Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We present to you lesson number 943 of our daily nasiha and advice. Our topic today is Sayyida Umme Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha. She, Umme Salama radiallahu anha's name is Hind bint Abi Umayya. She was married to Abu Salama and they migrated to Habasha, Ethiopia in Africa. And thereafter that she migrated to Medina Munawwara, here Abu Salama radiallahu ta'ala anhu passed away, and she read the dua. And this is a wonderful, powerful dua. Every person should read, Allah forbid, if and when calamities, disasters befall that person. Many a time people read this dua incorrectly. So she, Umme Salama radiallahu anha, read the dua. Allahumma jurni, join the meem with the alif. Allahumma jurni fi musibati. Oh beloved Allah, you reward me in my calamity, meaning you assist me, reward me. وَخْلُفْ لِي خَيْرًا مِنَا. Ya Allah, you took away this person, my husband, in this context, so give me someone better. But she herself would say, who could be better? Abu Salama radiallahu anha was such a great person, gentleman, good husband, good father. So all these type of things would go through her mind. So after her iddat, Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam proposed, and she said that, you know, that she's old and so forth and so on. But yet Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam told her, no, that it'll be good for her to get married. And Nabi sallallahu then married her. She, Umme Salama radiallahu anha, was a very, very intelligent lady, and she reported 378 ahadith from Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We take you back to the 6th year of the Hijrah, and it is on the occasion of Hudaybiyah. Now the Sahaba, after 6 years, all in Ihram, 1,500 of them approximately, and they really wanted to perform Umrah. But on that side, Khalid bin Walid, Abu Sufyan, all of them non-Muslim, they said, no, you can't come. And they were very reluctant. Nabi alayhi salatu salam said, okay, let us come out of Ihram. We shave our hair, come out of Ihram, and so forth. So they were reluctant because, not Allah forbid, they defying Nabi alayhi salam. They really thought that they will go for Umrah. So Umme Salama said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that you shave your hair and then see, lo and behold, the master alayhi salatu salam shaved his hair Mubarak, and then we see the Sahaba immediately followed because they love Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wasallam more than their spouses and their children as well. So that is again Umme Salama radiallahu anha showed her great opinion in that regard. So we see that she said that, Ya Rasulullah, we only find Allah Ta'ala addressing the men in the noble Quran, ya ayyuhallazina amanu, 89 times. Why the women are not addressed? And then we see Almighty Allah revealed the verse, innal muslimin al muslimat, wal mu'minin al mu'minat, wal qanitin al qanitat. So 10 qualities are mentioned there, that the Muslim men and the Muslim woman, the Muslim, you know, fasting men and the fasting woman, like that. So those who make zikr, male and female, charity, and so forth. So all this was because of Umme Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha. So the dua we should by heart when the calamity, musibat comes, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, verily we belong to Allah, unto Allah is the return. Allahumma ajurni fi musibati wa khluf li khayra minha. And Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam married her, and thereafter she passed away in the year 59, and she was 84 years old when she passed away. She is buried there in Baqi. We told you previously, all the wives, honorable wives of Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, buried there in Baqi in Medina Munawwara, except Sayyida Khadija radiallahu anha in Mualla in Makkah, and Sayyida Maymuna radiallahu anha day in Sarif, and that is 20-25 kilos out of Makkah Mukarramah. So may Almighty Allah grant us the true love for our honorable mothers, Quran calls them wa azwajuhu ummahatuhum. The honorable wives of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam are the mothers. Therefore, we say Ummul Mu'minin, Sayyida Aisha, Ummul Mu'minin, Sayyida Umme Salama, radiyallahu anhunna ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.